So we'll start with talking about how development got started to begin with. Basically, the Nintendo 3DS was first revealed to me personally just a few weeks before E3. I'd heard some rumors, of course, we knew they were up to something, but not until that point did I get to actually see it and hold it in my hands. At that moment, that was right when we had finished up Super Street Fighter 4, the version that's already out there. Just starting to relax after that, and then I got my hands on a 3DS, and it dawned on me that you know, this hardware is so powerful that it really could do a good job of replicating the feel, the experience that you get from playing Street Fighter 4 on other hardware, and it would give more people a chance to experience the kind of cool fighting action that this game can provide. So basically, after I first got to look at the 3DS, we assembled a very small team to begin experimenting and see if they could write some really simple code and get something up and running. It became very clear to us early on that we were going to be able to do some really cool things with this hardware. So I went and talked to Nintendo about it, told them we were interested in doing Super Street Fighter 4 3D Edition. They were really excited about it. They basically asked us to have a playable at E3, which given the timing wasn't really possible. We were able to throw together some screenshots and get some things ready. And we then spent the intervening months after that in close collaboration with Nintendo, figuring out new ways to get people interested in Street Fighter, new ways to bring back users that, you know, perhaps used to play Street Fighter 2 on the Super Nintendo, new interesting things we could do with this particular version of the game. So that's how things have been progressing since that point. So I spoke a little bit earlier about the driving philosophy, and this goes back to Street Fighter 4 itself as well, of, you know, trying to bring back people who used to enjoy Street Fighter 2, trying to welcome them back into the fray, so to speak. I think there's still plenty of people that kind of missed the boat on 4 and Super 4 and still haven't jumped in yet. Perhaps they're worried that the controls are too complicated. Perhaps it seems like things have progressed so much since they used to play that it's kind of a difficult world to get back into. So a lot of the new modes we're doing with this game are kind of an effort to once again kind of level the playing field, open the door even wider, get more people interested. You know, we have what we're calling Street Pass, which allows you to have the 3DS closed in your pocket, in your bag. Go out to the mall, do some shopping. While you're doing that, the game will actually sort of fight for you, so to speak. You have these figures that you win, and they will actually fight each other. We thought that'd be a nice kind of gateway into online battle modes, because if you're, you know, if this can happen kind of automatically, get you into it, you get these figures you collect, you can customize them, you can adjust their parameters, their strength, etc., customize the way they look, and then they kind of go on and fight for you. We figured if we could hook people that way, that might sort of lower the barrier of entry, lower the hurdle, for people who might now suddenly be a little interested in fighting online, even if they were perhaps timid about it before. So it's all, everything that drives these new modes is all about getting people to try modes they might not otherwise try through kind of different gateways. So basically, you know, these new features of the 3DS, these really cool Wi-Fi features allow us to experiment with these new kinds of modes. And, you know, once again, I'm hoping that people will sort of get interested in the concept of fighting other people, even if they hadn't been before, just because it's kind of a new way to experience it, a new way, you know, to experience, you know, these characters kind of fighting on your behalf against other people, that sort of thing. You know, there's two real aims for this. One, I hope that more and more 3DS games will begin to utilize this sort of feature because it is a really cool feature that the hardware has. And also, I hope it'll get people more interested in fighting games who may have presumed they were not into fighting games before. Hopefully, this will sort of awaken their inner fighter, so to speak. Yeah, so with the new over-the-shoulder 3D camera angle, basically we're looking at this as you know, providing multiple entryways into the same final destination. And what I mean by that is, you know, you raise a good point. Characters like Chun-Li, grappling characters like Zangief, Abel, etc., they don't work as well. I'm really completely upfront and honest with that. They don't work as well in that 3D angle because it's harder to gauge distances. What I'm hoping people will do is kind of naturally find which angle they like depending on which character they play as. You know, if you're an Abel player, if you're a Zangief player, please do use a traditional 2D camera. You'll thank me for it later. If you're using a character that's easier to get accustomed to and has a lot of projectiles, someone like Ken or you, you know, feel free to experiment with that new 3D angle. We think it just gives people who once again might not be as interested in fighting games something new to try, kind of a more dynamic camera angle. They're more than welcome to experiment with that. There's certainly no requirement to try that out. Certainly with some characters, I'd recommend that you not. The good news is that when you play online with other people with the Wi-Fi features, it's perfectly okay for one player to have the 2D angle and one player who might prefer the 3D angle to use that as well. So there's no rule that if someone else is using that angle, that you're obligated to do the same. So this game is, of course, for the 3DS. We're looking to have it in stores as close as possible to launch. We're going to get it out very early in the launch window, do our best to do that. So it won't be long before you can experience true arcade fighting in the palm of your hand, anywhere, anytime, play against anyone else all around the world. It is truly a new experience, and I hope you look forward to it.